Most people who do not succeed, you got tired. You smarter than me. I'm a high school dropout. You smarter than me.
I've been able to have E really fire me up, give me that passion, that drive to keep on pushing.
You have more resources than me. The only reason I beat most of you in this room is because when that lion is coming to get me, I let him know you're gonna get tired before I do.
Trust and believing is so important to get further into the process, and ET brings that to my level and really speaks to me.
You will not outdo me. Let's go. This is will. This ain't phenomenal skill. This is phenomenal will.
He told the guy, he said, when you want to succeed as bad as you want to breathe, then you'll be successful.
There are some things in life that you'll never experience, you'll never receive, that you will never obtain until you believe. Believe in you and believe in your dreams. So dream big and dream beyond your wildest imagination.
All right, on three, one, two, three. What up, what up, what up? It's your boy, E.T. Yeah! All right, let's go. So when I first start dreaming, like, and there's some of you in this room, you're new at dreaming. I'm not talking to my seasoned dreamers right now. I'm talking to those of you who are new at dreaming, like, you just start making money, like, you just start getting serious about life, right? And in your mind, you've got this idea, and what I want you to know is that whatever that ideal is that you haven't even started yet. Right, and this is critical because what we don't get is that we only accomplish what we think. Like whatever your mind is big enough to think, that's what you're gonna get. I want you to think in a way that scares your parents. I want you to go home and stuff you start talking to your mom about, I just want your mom to be terrified. Look, I'm being honest, like I want your mom to be like, son, you're doing too much. Nobody in our family has ever done that. Like I want your mom to say that kind. I want your dad to be like, son, be careful. Do you know what you're getting into, son? This is dangerous. This is dangerous territory. Nobody in our family has ever made millions of dollars in a matter of a few months. You're gonna kill yourself, son. It's just too much. No, like I'm being honest. Like I remember my mother, because she worked at Ford Motor Company for 30 years. When I started doing this work, my mother would call me and say, be careful, son. I said, be careful for what, mom? You got children and your son has asthma and you're leaving a full-time job at the university, son, and you don't have health benefits.
In 2010, I believe it was, Eric came to me, had this vision. He was gonna be what I called, being an entrepreneur. And he had found this sweet spot as far as I was concerned. I was so proud of him. He got his master's. He's been accepted to run a program at Michigan State. He had all the perks. He had some great benefits. Do you want to walk away from this for a maybe? My grandson had some health issues because he has asthma. And Dee was working, but Eric, it was so important for him to finally be in a position where he took care of his family.
So let me tell you what happens. Somebody got in my little brain. Somebody got into my working class, blue collar brain. Because when I grew up as a kid, all I saw my whole life was people getting up on my block and they were driving the Ford. And they were driving the Chrysler, and they were driving the GM. Like, that's Motown. Everybody was blue collar.
There wasn't a lot of thought about furthering your education because back then it was about the money. Nobody saw it coming to a screeching halt. I had friends that were third generation in the plant. They got in, their kid got in.
It wasn't even just in Detroit. The cool thing was, it was an option outside of dope. You know, it was an option out selling drugs. Like, drugs was like 50-50. Like, you weren't really like, you felt like you had to sell drugs. You was lazy if you sold drugs. You know what I'm saying? Like, you knew you could go work at the plant if you wanted to. Like, if you was willing to grind and you didn't want a part of that life, you can. I had friends that worked at the plant at Chrysler. For me, even if there was this somewhat talk of college, it was silenced. Ford, GM, and Chrysler, the big three was Like that was tangible.
Was it? Yeah.
Yeah, that's something you could touch. Right. You know what I'm saying? So for me, yeah, I wasn't, you know, I wasn't thinking about, you know, college as much. You know, I was thinking about, because that's why I didn't really pay attention in school. My thing was, if all fails, you know you can get a job.
Always had a job. Yeah. Always had a job.
I want to tell you something, guys. That lady that was so afraid for me, she now is employed by me, and she loves. I love my son. I love his job. I love everything he stands for. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Are you hearing what I'm saying to you? I'm telling you, my mom works for me now.
Eric didn't want me working for him, for one thing. He had this thing. He didn't want none of his family. But the funnier thing was he's always telling the HR girl, call my mom. She's got a business head, you know. She'll help you. And she said, you know, what would you require to work? And I said, you tell me a salary, and then if it's good, I'll accept it. I didn't argue. I took the job. Eric still don't know I'm working for him because I'm calling myself Vicky. And she says, your mom's working for her. And he said, what do you mean she's working for me? Who hired her? And she said, well, you're always telling her, asking me to call your mom to ask her questions. So we needed help, and I hired her. And so he actually put me on 90 days. He said, I'm giving you 90 days, Mom.
90 days,
my own son. And had to sign this paper that I would not divulge any of his information. And
it's business, y'all.
It's right. It's all business.
It's all business.
So I would do something good. He'd hear about it. He'd extend my contract for 30 days. And after a period of time, I haven't heard him mention that I'm still on parole. So I guess I've done good.
Hey, all I'm saying is this. It's business, y'all. Y'all think I'm out here playing when I say
he's
beast
not
mode.
Playing.
I'm not playing beast mode.
I'm telling you, my mom works for me now, right? My mom works for me now and loves entrepreneurship. Yes. For some time now, I've believed in my son and I believed in his vision. And as his mother, I'm here to support him. I'm like, Mom, you lied. You just said 2 years ago. Son, don't worry about that. I support you now. That's what matters.
There are blurred lines sometimes when you're dealing with family. And for my mom, I didn't know if my mom would have the ability, you know, to cut off the mother nurturing side. Somebody call, because there's people calling clowning. You know what I'm saying? There's people calling, you know, with all Eric needs to do this and Eric needs to do that, you know. And with my mother being the person that's answering the calls, you know, I didn't know if she had the ability not to cut somebody out who called tripping on her son, you know what I'm saying, flat out. And I'm like, Ma, that's not the brand. You know what I'm saying? Like, you got to be the brand. And so it's easy, you know, you guys think things are easy, but when there's a, you know, principle over feelings. And so my thing with my mom was like, look, I already know what you can do skill set wise. I don't know if you don't have the ability to call, I don't know if you don't have the ability to, you know, to stop the neck, you know, and the finger boy and go off on somebody, you know. And that was my concern. And so my thing was just like, yo, Mom, if you have the ability to be professional under all circumstances, of course I'd rather have you because I know you're a stakeholder. You know, I know that I can trust you, you know, but at the same time, I just gotta make sure that, you know, you're gonna be professional under all circumstances, you know. But to the glory of God, it has worked out, you know, phenomenally. She's going to be coming out, you know, hopefully next year with her own book, you know, and a little bit more
right.
visible in terms of helping parents out there, you know, who want to know how to, you know, raise kids in this generation. Because you saw me with the not funny video. Yeah, I didn't get it from me. I got it from my mom. You know what I'm saying? It's just you're gonna respect me. You know what I'm saying? You give respect, you give love, you nurture, you expect people to respond, you know, in the appropriate manner. So I get it from my mama, you know what I'm saying? So so yeah, guys, what you wanna say as we wrap up, dream, you know, dream big, you know? And the one thing I can accredit to my family is that, you know, we were taught, my sisters and I were taught by our parents that each generation should get better. You know what I'm saying? Each generation should get better. And man, Ford, GM, whatever, Chrysler, like my mom said, there was a day in Detroit where that was what was happening, you know?
But things have changed,
you know? And so you have to change. You have to have a growth mindset and not a fixed mindset because things do change. So, hey, it's your boy E.T. saying dream big. Remember, if it was easy to do, everybody would do it. I'm not saying it's gonna be easy, but I am saying if you're watching, you have internally what it takes to make it happen. So make the rest of your life the best of your life.
There are some things in life that you'll never experience, you'll never receive, that you will never obtain until you believe. Believe in you and believe in your dreams. So dream big and dream beyond your wildest imagination.